obviously you have some countries that are have their own problems of legitimacy. The government of Brazil, which is headed by Jair Bolsonaro, he came to power in an election that was of questionable legitimacy because they excluded the most popular politician in Brazil, Lula da Silva, the former president, and they put him in jail so he couldn't run. Well, they also made a separate court decision that he couldn't run from jail. But he was jailed and convicted without any real material evidence against him. It was all based on one plea bargained, the whole case was based on one plea bargained witness who was convicted of corruption, and his plea bargaining was cut off until he changed his story and supported the investigating, prosecuting judge's view in what he wanted. So that was very questionable. And then they prevented Lula from speaking to the media. And of course, they wouldn't have even gotten rid of the Workers' Party, Lula's party, and had this opportunity if they hadn't impeached Dilma Rousseff, the president from the Workers' Party. In 2015 and 16, they proceeded against her with an impeachment that didn't actually have a real crime. So all of this was really unconstitutional, illegal, and that's how Jair Bolsonaro, who's most famous for his horrible remarks, you know, telling a fellow member of Congress, a woman, that he wouldn't rape her because she didn't merit it, and saying all these terrible racist and homophobic things and glorifying violence. He once said that the Brazilian dictatorship should have killed 30,000 people instead of 3,000. And so this is the kind of president you have. And so you have an ideological affinity with Trump. So, you know, and you have also this question of legitimacy.